I'm busy. Oh my god, I'm working. You need to get down. Or you can sit, but okay, cool. She's gonna sit with me. Welcome back. I'm Zanim Vulan. You're watching Girl Boss South Africa. Today we're talking about cowrie shells. They've become a huge fashion statement in the African continent and the diaspora. It is a statement that originates in Africa. They've been used by humans for a very long time as food supply. They've been used as currency, as decoration. They've been used as adornment. They've been used as protective amulets and also tools for spiritual divination. I know my mom uses them as a diviner. She uses them as part of her collection of divination tools. Cowrie shells derive from small snail-like creatures that are native to the Indian and the Pacific Oceans. In the African belief system, cowrie shells speak a symbolic spiritual language on artifacts, on clothes, garments. They speak a spiritual language about our past, our present, and our future. The natural history of cowrie shells starts with basically just looking at seashells. Seashells as a food source are rich in proteins and they have mineral nutrients. They're still to this day in abundance and they're really easy to get on thousands of miles of coastlines. Like, our human population is absolutely nothing compared to the cowrie shell population in the ocean. Scientists often speak of shells that they discovered even up to 500 million years back. Cowries have about 200 species and they have an intensely massive breeding habit. A habit that's prevented them from becoming endangered, especially because of how popular they are in African culture today and throughout our history. They can lay from 100 to 1,500 eggs at a time, just in one single breeding period. And their sizes range from a fifth of an inch to about 6 inches. They kind of camouflage themselves in the coral reef during the day, and then they come out to eat at night. They eat mostly algae or just dead tropical matter in the tropical ocean around the coral reef. The smaller, durable yellow cowries are the ones that have mostly been in high demand throughout our history. They also have always come in various color patterns, you know, with yellow, brown, purple, and white. And they've always been collected and used throughout even the ancient times in Kemet, in Ghana, in Nubia. Before they even became known as a really great food source, they were always used within ancient African cultures. There are a lot of historical records that show the use of cowrie shells spiritually in Kemet. Aesthetically, they were always attractive to the eyes and the spirits of Africans. Archaeological research shows approximately 750,000 years ago, drawings by Africans of cowrie shells on cave walls. And archaeological excavations also reveal that during the pre-dynastic Kemet period, many of the people that were buried in gravesites were actually buried with cowrie shell necklaces. Then the cowrie shell became less about its aesthetic value and became currency in foreign exchange in Kemet. A lot of pharaohs that were buried were found to have been buried with cowrie shell necklaces, and this symbolized their wealth and status. The cowrie shells that had an aesthetic that were harder to find are the ones that were worth more. Besides its value as natural currency, it also resonated with Black people thousands of years ago because of its shape. The bottom side resembled the yoni of a woman, and the top side resembled a pregnant woman. So it was seen as a living organism that had come from the vast ocean to represent the physical features that defined the female human, with her sexual organs and her womb. So the cowrie shell's natural design primarily encouraged women in Kemet to wear them on their clothing. They wore them on their belts, they wore them as jewelry, and then they transcended from jewelry to amulets. Amulets were very significant in the spiritualized social environment of Kemet. Women were encouraged to wear a cowrie shell belt during their pregnancy to protect their unborn children and themselves from any misfortune. The cowrie shells acted as a catalyst to enhance the belief that they would survive the childbearing phase and the childbirthing phase, and that they would have a healthy baby. The power of the belief in African ancestry has always been very important, especially when there was a need to protect alive or to connect to God or goddess. Cowrie shells acted as a catalyst to enhance those ceremonies and those rituals and the connections, connecting with the gods, connecting with the ancestors, and protecting themselves in the space. Africans have always been very talented at taking a natural element and spiritualizing it and using it as a spiritual tool. This is how we were able to take cowrie shells from the tropical ocean water and turn it into a sacred spiritual symbol for generations of descendants of Black people to come. On the west coast of Africa, approximately in the 14th century, cowrie shells were used as much as gold was used as currency. But even then, it didn't last too long. It dwindled as currency, and they were instead elevated more as a spiritual tool. They became a big part of sacred African art. They were incorporated in the masks, in the sculptures, and all of that art would then become incorporated into ceremonies and rituals, and they were believed to be able to cause people to transcend emotionally and spiritually. And we still have a lot of this kind of art to this day. We see a lot of African masks with cowrie shells incorporated, little sculptures. It's a really great way to adorn your house with spiritually charged art. It creates a spiritual ambience, especially for someone who's in touch with their African roots. I know in my family, we've always been kind of into that stuff from even before we got in touch with our African roots. I think it was just a way of subconsciously connecting to our roots. And there are many ways to do that. And that is one of the ways, because art, artistic expression, is the African way. It is very African in nature. So I hope that provides a little bit of context in terms of, now when you're wearing your cowrie jewelry, it's very beautiful, it is aesthetically pleasing, but there is, you know, a root behind it and there is a history behind it. So I think we can be more conscious, if we can be more conscious as Africans when we wear cowries, the spiritual significance of them and how they connect to the feminine divine and how they connect us to our ancestry as well, and how they also connect us to the water spirits, the spirits of the ocean, which are very significant in African spirituality, in our cultural history. And not only did they serve as an economic currency, but also as spiritual currency. They symbolize our spiritual wealth. Thank you so much for watching. That's it from me. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. I will see you in the next video. What do you know about cowrie shells that I may have forgotten to mention? Pop in the comments to let me know. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And take care of yourselves, guys. Love and light.